Hello there. I thought tonight we'd do another deck tech, this time on Grand Moff Tarkin Green. I've been getting asked for quite a few more deck techs, so I think we'll probably see some of those coming your way soon. This is a really fun deck, partly because it is incredibly flexible. It can be the aggro, it can be the control, and it can switch kind of on a dime more than most other decks. So you can see the basic deck that we have laid out here. And there's nothing super revolutionary about this deck. I think what really makes it work is Tarkin himself. Tarkin's ability to give out experience for resource to basically everything in the deck, the one exception is the Consortium Star Viper, is super, super strong. It can let you get some really, really positive trades. It can let you build some massive, overwhelming barrage targets. And so we'll talk through what this looks like. For our opening turn, we've got Tag, Yularen, Shore Trooper, Snowtrooper Lieutenant, and a TIE Fighter. And the only bad option here is really Tag. Everything else is a good option. You might think that this deck struggles against aggro. I really don't think it does. Yularen in the first turn is basically like having three extra health for your base, because if they don't kill Yularen, they're going to wish that they had. Royal Guard becomes a 3-4 Sentinel with Yularen out. And then we've got more Sentinels with the cell block guard. So if they don't kill Yularen on turn one, we're going to do a ton of healing, and they're going to struggle to get to him. The TIE Fighter is also a fine play, because if we play the TIE, we can tap Tarkin to turn him into a 3-2, which trades just fine with an A-Wing, right? We've still got that one Consortium Star Viper to deal with pesky A-Wings. But our space lane kind of looks weak because there's not a lot of health here. But if our opponent doesn't have a space unit, we can go absolutely crazy in space. Part of the power of this deck, too, is the seasoned Shore Trooper. So it's a good turn one play. You know, we can probably boost it with experience later or Snow Trooper Lieutenant it. But late in the game, when you're drawing your early drops like your two drop cards, a snow seasoned Shore Trooper is absolutely fine, because he's basically a 4-3, and that can help out close out games, which is great. Coming in at three resources, we have Emperor's Royal Guard, Super Laser Technician, Cell Block Guard, Veers, and the Consortium Star Viper. These are all decent plays. But really, what we're looking for, hopefully, is a resupply or a super laser technician. In some matchups, that might not be the case. Veers is an interesting one. He doesn't get played in a lot of decks because he's so easy to remove. But again, in this aggro matchup, he's basically three more health for your base, because he makes all the other units get so much stronger that they basically have to kill him. And in a mid-range matchup, you know, if you can get Veers and a Royal Guard out, it starts getting pretty nuts. Not only that, but Tarkin can keep boosting us. But it's not the end of the world if we don't get a Super Laser Technician or Veers, because this deck is running nine ramp cards. You can see that we're light on fours, right? Because on the unit side, the TIE Advanced is the only four drop. So command comes in at four, and it's just incredible. Typically, we're giving two experience tokens to a unit and putting in as a resource, but the other abilities are also amazing. A friendly unit deals damage equal to its power to a non-unique enemy unit. With Tarkin's ability, we're basically never going to miss out on resources that we should have been able to spend. We're always going to build something bigger. And so that, mini overwhelming barrage on this one can also deal with A-wings, right? So if we build a seasoned shore trooper, give it an experience, now it can kill A-wings. The ramp is also good, right? Because it helps us get those seasoned shore troopers pumped up even faster. And then I think a lot of people overlook the last one, return a unit from your discard pile to your hand. That's phenomenal. That's a lot of times better than drawing a card because you can draw that sentinel that you need again. You can draw back a Yularen that they killed early. And if we played Emperor's Royal, let's say our turn one was Yularen, turn two was Royal Guard, but they killed Yularen. Well, we can play command on turn three and get Yularen back. Now they're not going to be able to get to him, and we're going to get to heal a ton of damage from base. So it's really quite good. Five, we basically want to play Overwhelming Barrage. We want to have built a giant unit with Tarkin, and we want to basically blow out the game at this point by maybe having beers and a Emperor's Royal Guard that has been super buffed and has a couple experience, and then we are overwhelming barrage on him. And it can get pretty nasty when you start thinking about cards like the TIE Advance. If we don't get overwhelming barrage, we're probably going to be on the defensive a little bit. Traitorous can come into play to steal something to help us out quite a bit. Callus can try to get us back in the game, as can Rook. So Rook's there with Energy Conversion Lab to basically try to bring us back. And then you'll see not really any sixes. We're probably playing multiple threes on that turn. And then Vader is an amazing finisher. In this deck, a lot of times Vader's grabbing a cell block guard. A lot of times he's grabbing Veers. Emperor's Royal Guard is amazing. But a lot of decks actually miss out on the two-unit grab. So if Vader can grab a seasoned shore trooper and a TIE fighter, that's basically grabbing six attack, which can be quite powerful to help you close out the game. And then I do run Devastator as well at the top end. A lot of times when you're on eight resources, you'll start drawing your resupplies and stuff like that, and you might as well resource them. And if things get out of hand, Devastator is kind of your win condition at the end. Typically, you've won the game before that, but it's good to have in the deck. In terms of sideboard options for this deck, more Devastator is good. And for that control matchup, Reinforcement Walker is great. A lot of times we've won the game before we would even get to that point. But if we're up against, something super control like an Iden or a Palpatine, Reinforcement Walker is another good option to Overwhelming Barrage. Confiscate is not bad. It's mostly there to play against other traitors, right? A lot of times we're going to turn some little unit into an absolute monster. And if that monster gets hit by traitorous, our options are to traitorous it back or confiscate. So that can be a good one. Academy training is kind of an honorable mention. I don't really see the need for this too often, because typically you can just use Tarkin's ability. It's a little stronger in that it can smooth things out, but most of the time I don't end up needing it. And then Escort Skiff. In a super aggressive aggro matchup, I might sub out Rook for Escort Skiff, maybe Devastator for Escort Skiff, because in that matchup, if you've got an evader, you probably have the win. So I want to just maybe play some sample hands out real quick, just to kind of show you the power of the deck and how it can build a absolute monster early on in the first couple turns with Tarkin's ability. actually played a game earlier today where I had an 8-power unit on turn 3 after my opponent had played a Spark of Rebellion. He had the option to strip my most valuable card, and I still just created an absolute monster. So obviously a bad hand because we didn't get a 2-drop. We should expect to get one because we have quite a few options. We're not going to be picky. Okay, we got one. This will work. Might not be the best case scenario, but we'll play with it. It looks like I might be still didn't do the greatest job shuffling, so we'll resource the cell block guards. Okay. So turn one, we're gonna play a Snowtrooper Lieutenant. Turn two, we probably don't need this Snowtrooper Lieutenant. So this is where, a lot of times we want to resupply, but maybe we're fine. Let's pretend that our opponent killed our Snowtrooper Lieutenant because it's weak, and that's fine. So let's play a cell block guard out for three. Okay. Next turn. Here we go. We probably can resource Rook. Here's where we play command. Okay, we'll pretend the cell block guard hasn't been killed. If we play command for four, we can give the cell block guard two experience and put it in as a resource. That same round, we can deploy Tarkin, attack with Tarkin, and give the cell block guard another experience. So now we have a 6-6 and our leader out on basically, two turns in. If they don't kill the cell block guard at this point, right? So it's a new round. Let's see, we're going to six. If they don't kill it, Overwhelming Barrage is basically close to game over, right? Because now I'm doing 8 resources worth of damage to them, and I'm not even done, right? So let's say I do that. They somehow get rid of my cell block guard. Well, now I start building in space, and Tarkin builds a 3 attack in space that can potentially Overwhelming Barrage you again. So it really can get quite nuts. I'll show you the line that I had earlier today, which worked out quite nicely for me. So turn one was Seasoned Shore Trooper. Okay, he sparked my hand and he pulled a cell block guard out of it. My turn two was actually General Tag. That doesn't feel great, right? So now I'm at 3 resources. I play tag for two. You feel like you want to get extra experience out of tag. One experience doesn't feel all that great, but Tarkin's helps make things easy, right? So I used Tarkin to give the Shore Trooper another experience. And guess what I had for the next turn? So my Seasoned Shore Trooper stayed alive, and I think he, managed to trade and kill something on their side. They ended up killing Tag because they could, I think. My next turn, I played Command, so I got him up 2 more experience, and I think I put it in as a resource. Then Tarkin came out and attacked and gave him another experience. So now I've got a 7-8 attacking, and when I just naturally resource the next turn, he's a 9-8, right? Because he gets the +2 here. So, obviously there are ways to try to deal with that. There's upgrade removal, there's trading with the little units and power of the dark side, but that was like, that was suboptimal play. That was playing tag for just one experience and then a card that you can pretty much count on getting, right? Command. All the other experience came from Tarkin. So basically 3 cards which aren't even the best cards in the deck, just became an absolute monster to deal with. So I think this deck is quite fun. You can swap out Tarkin for Palpatine. My build changes quite a bit if I do that. But it's still a strong deck. So I hope that you will play with it and enjoy it. And let me know what you're looking for next.